So when I first walked out the theater, there was this woman in front of me. She was like, I hated it. It was horrible. It sucked. I walked up to her and I was like, why? It was just random and all over the place. I said, it's a Spike Lee movie. What do you expect? I'm Brandon Keith Avery, and this is just my opinion. So Spike Lee is back as the writer and director for Chi-Raq. Just talking about the characters, there's a ton of people in this film that you know. Samuel Jackson, he did a great job. He does a great job in everything he does. He had a bunch of loud suits and was more of the narrator of the film. And I liked his role in the film. So Samuel Jackson did a great job. Wesley Snipes did a great job. Of course, Angela Bassett did a great job. Even John Cusack did a great job. Tanoia Paris did a great job too. She was last in Dear White People, and I really didn't care for that movie, but she was one of the driving forces in Chi-Raq. Her character's name was Lysistra. Lysistra's character just like, look, I am the girlfriend of one of the biggest gangsters out there. I'm gonna have to start this movement. If I want all this violence to stop, I'm not gonna give them any. And it spoke volumes. I mean, I really did like that. I don't care how silly you think it is. I mean, at least she's out there trying. I mean, she's doing something. And just on my personal taste, the natural hair that she was rocking in this film, oh my gosh, she looked beautiful. But hey, that's just me, but I did really love her natural hair. And the film is not only titled Chi-Raq, Chi-Raq is the name of Nick Cannon's character. And I have to be honest when I say this, I am a Nick Cannon fan, but he did absolutely horrible in this film. He was atrocious. Him trying to play a thugged out gangster was ridiculous. As soon as he popped onto the screen trying to do his thing, I was like, oh my God, stop, cut. We need to get another actor in there because he is not doing a great job at all trying to portray some thugged out gangster. I mean, he just looked ridiculous. Now, what was surprising was Jennifer Hudson was in this film too, but she did a horrible job at acting as well. I mean, I don't understand. I mean, she can act. She did a great job in Dreamgirls. She did a great job in all the other films that she was in. I don't understand what happened. There was a few nice cameos in the movie. I don't want to ruin them for you here. You have to see it for yourself. But one gentleman in particular, I was like, whoa, man, I haven't seen you in like a decade. And the short time that he was on screen, I liked it. He made me laugh. He was very funny. Now, what I also liked about the film was the poetic nature in the dialogue. It was very different. I haven't really seen anything like that before. I don't want to call this film a musical. I'm not a real fan of musicals or stage plays. I've seen musicals before and I've gone to stage plays. And one thing in stage plays I just don't really like is how they're having dialogue and they just bust out into song. Yes, this film did have that throughout in different points, but it wasn't all over the place, all in your face. I mean, when they did it, it was nice and subtle and not over the top, and I really did enjoy that. Now, I want to take a step back addressing Nick Cannon. Yes, his acting was absolutely horrible. It was probably one of the worst performances I've seen all year, but when I started to think about it, I wouldn't be surprised if Spike Lee told Nick Cannon, I want you to act bad on purpose, because that's gonna make the film much better. Now you're probably saying, Brandon, what are you talking about? Why would the director want one of his main actors in the film to act bad? And that goes with the message that the film is trying to convey. The whole message of the film is to stop all the bullshit and this dumb gang violence and being blind loyal to a cause that only causes death. And if you think about it, there are a lot of people out there in these gangs, organized gangs, or whatever you want to call it, and they just are blind loyal to the streets and just follow a cause that doesn't cause anything but tyranny and death and sad and pain and crying eyes. And so what the film did, which really I liked, is they had all the characters over exaggerate. I mean, I guess you can call it exploitation, and they just was acting ridiculous. Some of the actors and actresses did a great job, some did not, with that being Nick Cannon. But I mean, he looked very dumb in his role. He looked stupid trying to portray a thugged out gangster. So his bad acting could have helped the film portray that, look how stupid you look. Look how dumb you're acting. Look at this life that you're living that's causing nothing but death around you. And I think it worked. I mean, I've never seen a film where bad acting actually could have made the film better. And people with this mindset that they just want to go out and kill, kill, kill for no reason, that is ridiculous. Take Wesley Snipes for an interest. His character's name was Cyclops. He's like 50, 60 years old, black as hell, walking around with an eye patch that has red sparkly glitter on it. I mean, that is crazy looking. And the way he acted in this role, I mean, it was great. I mean, everybody was over-exaggerating. Everybody was looking ridiculous in their role, trying to portray like, guys, look, this is how you really look out there, trying to be loyal to the streets. And it's just ruining the black community, and it just needs to stop. So the message is great. I really did love that. It's just like, look, we need to put the guns down and stop all this violence and come together for the greater good. I really do appreciate that. I really do like it. I mean, they did a great job there. And about the overall message, Spike Lee did a great job at telling it to you in a funny way and in a serious way. And this film, it shoves it in your face, but at least it tastes good. It's a nice message that just goes down smoothly. And I ate it all up. I mean, I loved it. Now, this film is not perfect, to say the least. There are some things that fell flat on its face, especially the bad acting from Jennifer Hudson and Nick Cannon. But overall, it was a great film that I really enjoyed, and I really recommend it. If I would have to rate this film out of 1 out of 10, I would give it an 8 out of 10. But guys, that is just my opinion. Have you seen it? Do you want to see it? Have I turned you off? Have I turned you on? Do you agree with me, or do you disagree with me? Let me know in the comments section below. Let's get this conversation going and keep it flowing. If you like this video, go ahead and give me the thumbs up. And if you didn't like this video, that's fine. Just leave me a comment in the comment section below, letting me know why, and still give me the thumbs up. Since you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and subscribe to the YouTube channel. So become one of my subscribers and get all the content that I have in the past and in the future. And if you would like a written review of this or any of the other films I've covered in the past, head over to the site. You can find it at www.justmyopinion.net. And if you would like to find the official Facebook page, you can go to facebook.com/justmyopinion. And if you're into social media, which I'm sure you are, you can find me at Instagram and Twitter at justmyopinion84. So guys, thank you for tuning in. Give me that thumbs up, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, head over to the website, find me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all that good stuff, and share the video. And guys, before you go, don't forget that my name is Brandon Keith Avery, and that's just my opinion. Peace.